Jumpers with Zola.
Namhlanje we've got Mr. Gregory Maqoma and Umdu Nkwenyama. How are you?
We are fabulous.
We are
fabulous.
Fine, thank you.
Yeah, yeah.
So tell us about King Kong.
Well, King Kong is a South African musical, very historical. Mm. It started it was first presented in 1959.
Wow.
And it's a story of Ezekiel Dlamini, who adopted the name of King Kong as a legendary boxer.
Mm.
Uh-huh.
And it opened in South Africa at Wits Great Hall in 1959. And, and they had about 200 performances, which were amazingly well received.
Yeah.
Also, it was the first South African black musical,
wow,
which went on to tour in the UK, and it opened at West End.
Yeah.
And it's been really phenomenal in that way, because it's also a musical that gave birth to our own icons like Miriam Makeba, Ibrahima Sekela, and many more like Jonas Gwangwa and many more others who are South African based.
So what are your roles? Both you guys are Skalo Ngomtu.
I'm an associate director for production, so basically assistant director. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I'm Maqoma. I'm the choreographer of the show.
I've known Maqoma since 1919, by the way.
Yay, Fantuka!
We went to the same school.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Dancing.
Kanti wazukujayiva.
I left, I couldn't.
Don't know about Kula Ganji. Smangele tina haolo muntu wa Kula. Simaza yi
dance.
I think the last one man hander I saw you do was called Womanicity. If you made a mistake.
No, I think you're making a mistake.
Yeah.
It was probably Beautiful Me.
That's a long time ago.
It's
though.
It's a very
there
long time ago.
There were boxes on stage.
Oh, that's Rhythm City. The Rhythm 1, 2, 3. So not
yes, 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 yes. And somebody paid for us to come in for free, Siyokubukela. So
okay, at least somebody paid for you. You
know?
They watched it for free, but you got paid. It's fine.
So I'm being told Uguti there are plans with this musical. Uguti, it's gonna travel.
Yep. Definitely is going to travel. We're going to take it to Europe, and starting in France, and then it's going to go also to the UK. And as well, they are talking to other places as well in Europe. And also, no. come with us by all means. You know?
I mean, he's already a dancer, so I'm showing him faka ku background.
Exactly. And it's already been successful because we had a 5 weeks run in Cape Town at the Fugard Theatre, which was completely sold out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes.
I'm giving the recession, and people are still loving the arts.
Yeah.
It's like coming to theatre.
And
it's
people
fantastic.
Not having water to bath and come watch the show.
Yeah, you know what I mean.
I was worried a couple of years back when there were a bit of problems with the dance umbrella, and I thought, are people walking away from the dance?
Yeah.
What's happening? All of those things were in my mind. Recession, I want to afford and whatever. And I'm glad if this has come back and it's sold out. Ian in Ekaslet.
It's allowed me. Now we're opening this week in A12, September.
Mm-hmm.
We're opening at Joburg Theatre.
Yeah.
Wow.
We're going to have a 4 weeks run in Joburg, so people must get their tickets. It is amazing. I cannot even speak more about it because it is really, really, it's an amazing production.
Okay, for those who have not seen live music being mixed with dance and choreography and acting, I know it takes a hell of a lot of work before the curtains can open. Break it down, gentlemen. Because I know it's a lot of work.
Sure.
It is a lot of work. We started rehearsing this year, July, but the actual work started last year.
Yeah.
Mid last year, auditioning, finding people who can actually act properly and sing well and move. So it's a lot of work. And then once you come into the space with the actors and then the script. Analyzing the script to just understand what people are saying, what story are they telling, why are they telling it, you know what I mean, before we actually go to the flow. There's just way too much research that has to go in before your first step to the flow.
Only on Massive Metro.